أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر والملائكة والكتاب والنبيين وآتى المال على حبه ذوي القربى واليتامى والمساكين وابن السبيل والسائلين وفي الرقاب وأقام الصلاة وآتى الزكاة والموفون بعهدهم إذا عاهدوا والصابرين في البأساء والضراء وحين البأس أولئك الذين صدقوا وأولئك هم المتقون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم القصاص في القتلى الحر بالحر والعبد بالعبد والأنثى بالأنثى فمن عفي له من أخيه شيء فاتباع بالمعروف وأداء إليه بإحسان ذلك تخفيف من ربكم ورحمة فمن اعتدى بعد ذلك فله عذاب أليم. ولكم في القصاص حياة يا أولي الألباب لعلكم تتقون. كتب عليكم إذا حضر أحدكم الموت إن ترك خيرا الوصية للوالدين والأقربين بالمعروف حقا على المتقين. فمن بدله بعدما سمعه فإنما إثمه على الذين إن الله سميع عليم. فمن خاف من موص جنفا أو إثما فأصلح بينهم فلا إثم عليه إن الله غفور رحيم. يا كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. أياما معدودات فمن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر وعلى الذين يطيقون فإنه فدية طعام مسكين فمن تطوع خيرا فهو خير له وأن تصوموا خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصمه ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداع إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون أحل لكم ليلة الصيام الرفث إلى نسائكم هن لباس لكم وأنتم لباس لهن علم الله أنكم كنتم تختانون أنفسكم فتاب عليكم وعفى عنكم فالآن باشروهن وابتغوا ما كتب الله لكم وكلوا واشربوا حتى يتبين لكم الخيط الأبيض من الخيط الأسود من الفجر ثم أتموا الصيام إلى الليل ولا تباشروهن وأنتم عاكفون في المساجد تلك حدود الله فلا تقربوها كذلك يبين الله آياته للناس لعلهم يتقون ولا تأكلوا أموالكم بينكم بالباطل وتدلوا بها إلى الحكام لتأكلوا فريقا من أموال الناس بالإثم وأنتم تعلمون صدق الله العظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. As we continue our beloved and blessed journey through the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I bring our attention tonight to some selected verses from Surah Al-Baqarah, particularly starting with Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 183, in which here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes for us the reason for the blessed month of Ramadan. Or rather, what we should intend to get out of this blessed month. Alhamdulillah, we've completed our first fast today, and we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts this from us and makes it a means of our entrance into paradise. Allahumma ameen. So let's look back on why we even fast to begin with. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks to the believers and says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. This title in and of itself deserves a little bit of attention. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes or talks to Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referencing? That's us, the believers. Again, Islam is entry level. Iman is higher than that. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to the Muslims, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to everyone. But those that have allowed, or who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed faith to seep into their hearts, those are the believers, and those are the ones who are described in the Quran many times as having the highest levels of reward. So we want to be from Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. So whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins an ayah with this phrase, then we should listen up, we should look at it, we should try to investigate it, we should see what is being addressed here so that this verse will describe me. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who have believed, kutiba alaykum as-siyam, kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum, that fasting has been prescribed for you. Kutiba alaykum. I love this description. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the ultimate healer. Each and every one of us has illnesses of our heart and our soul. The way to find the prescription, or the way to fulfill the prescription of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who is perfect in his cure, is to follow the directions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fasting is a means of cleansing and healing our souls. With all of the trouble and turmoil that our lives are going through at any point in our day, at any point in our life, at any point in our existence, fasting is the cure. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. We are not the first people who were commanded to fast. We are not the first people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded them to leave something which is normally permissible for a short amount of time so that an individual can train their soul. No, this has come in commandments before us, but it has been prescribed upon us. كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. For what purpose? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. This, my friends, this is the fruit of why we fast. This is what we hope to attain by all of this effort, going those 18 some odd hours in some parts of the world without food and drink, going all of that time, whether it's in the summer, in the winter, whatever difficulties, whether you still have to work, whether you've still got sports practice, whatever the case may be, those things which we prioritize for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those things which we leave for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of that is meant for us to be able to attain taqwa, consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And consciousness, in a short summary, we could spend an entire session just talking about taqwa, but in summary, consciousness is awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That knowing and understanding the attributes and the names and the characteristics of Allah, and applying those to how we live our lives. So here it's one thing to understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is as-sami', all-hearing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-alim, all-knowing. And then it's a whole other thing to apply that knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the way I live and work and play and go about my daily life. So that when I walk, I know that Allah knows where I'm walking. So that when I look at something, I know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what I'm looking at. Nothing escapes the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you live your life basically under the recorder of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you're aware that you're being recorded, right? We all act differently when we're on tape. We all act differently when somebody is filming us. So when you act that way, you're always giving your best. That is taqwa. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So the point of us fasting is so that we can train our bodies, so that we can train our souls, so that we can be aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How long is one supposed to fast? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ. That these are specific days throughout the year. For us, alhamdulillah, the month of Ramadan will be 29 or 30 days. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has deemed it to be. أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ. Once you fill this prescription, right? Imagine you're sick. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from all illnesses. Imagine you're sick, you go to the doctor looks you over and does an exam, and then determines that this or this is your situation. So here's the prescription, take it to the pharmacy, go fill it, and you'll be fine after 2 to 3 weeks, take it 2 or 3 times a day, whatever the case may be. I'm not a physician. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you take my prescription, أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ, for this certain amount of days, and you will find and attain taqwa, consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أياماً معدودات. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows for some excuses, because maybe this prescription is not right for everyone at every single time in their lives, except for فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ, whoever you is ill or on a traveling, فَعِدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ. So this individual should make up their fasting later. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then continues to describe, right, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. That's why we investigate, and that's why we study, and that's why we attach ourselves to the Qur'an in this blessed month, because Ramadan is the month in which the revelation began to descend upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it is also mentioned, according to some of the tafsir, that in that day, in the month of Ramadan, is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed it to Jibreel in its entirety. And it was also within the month of Ramadan, perhaps, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed Jibreel to begin revealing the Qur'an to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. What is the Qur'an? هُدًى لِلنَّاسِ وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِّنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ. The Qur'an is guidance for humanity. For humanity, not just for the Muslims. So in the Qur'an, we find guidance on what we should do, what we should stay away from, what is allowable, what is impermissible. We find information about our history, because if we don't know where our history is, then we don't know where our future is headed. We find within it the prophecies of akhirah, heaven and hell, and the things that are to come later on in our existence and before the end of time. And we find within the Qur'an, as far as hudan linnas, we find within it as well descriptions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that we can better understand who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who we worship. Hudan linnas wa bayyinati min al-huda wal-furqan. فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمُ الْشَهْرِ فَلْيَصُمْ. And whoever is allowed to witness that blessed month, whoever is allowed to see the hilal and then receives information about the new moon, فَلْيَصُمْ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again repeats, because this faith is not rigid, right? This faith is one that is adaptable to our lives by the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again brings the concept of وَمَنْ كَانَ مَرِيدًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ فَعِدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامُ الْأُخَرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes ease for us and does not wish hardship for us. Then by the end of this page, in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in ayah number 186, listen here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking you to seek from Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Muhammad, Ya Muhammad, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِ عَنِّي. Ya Muhammad, if my slaves ask you about me, then what do you tell them? فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is close. In all of those situations and all of those moments of your life where you felt like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was not listening, where you felt like, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where you felt like everyone was against you, or you were all alone, or that you had no helper, you had no way through, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, listen, فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. I am close. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here guarantees that your dua will be answered so long as you make it. What do we have to do? Make the effort. What is happening with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It will be answered, and that is the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us. إِذَا دَعَانَ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِهِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. So let them call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and let us believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we will definitely attain success. I leave you with this bit of advice with regards to dua. That however, whenever, whoever you ask, whoever is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, however, whenever you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your dua is answered. Let me make this clear one more time, I'm going to say it. Your dua is always answered. Your dua will be answered in one of, or perhaps more, of three ways. Number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer that dua exactly as you asked for it at that exact moment. Number two, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your dua, will say yes, but not right now. Perhaps by the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're not ready to get the dua answered yet. So it will be number one, yes, immediately as you asked for it. Number two, it could be yes, but not yet. Or number three, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also with that number two, that it could come yet, is that Allah may reserve the reward or the answer of your dua in Jannah. And that would be the ultimate way to get your dua answered. Because if whatever it is that you're seeking, you're able to get the Jannah equivalent of it, oh, that's the deal that I want to take. Wallahu a'lam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers in the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So number one, immediately as you asked for it. Number two, yes, but not yet. Or three, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may remove some harm that was headed in your direction equivalent to the dua that you made. So we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it within our hearts to continue to ask, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala count us from amongst the believers, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive each and every one of us, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our fasting. Allahumma ameen, wa sadaqallahu al-aliyyil azeem, wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.